a raging patriot. Welcome to KSOK Uncensored. I need to change my intro out because I'm a little upset with Trump right now. But anyways, hey, welcome. Thank you guys for coming on a little bit late. As you guys know, things happen and I know you hang in there with me and I really appreciate that. And it's worth the wait because today we have On the Daily with Dahlia. We have Dahlia here and she's amazing and she does so much and gets the word out. And so just really honored to have her on as today's guest. Want to just take a minute and address what happened in Afghanistan today. It's just absolutely horrible. And at this point in time, I do believe the number is 12 U.S. military killed in action. I'm sure the number will grow as we gain more information, but just really upsetting. And it was also quite upsetting. I made sure to tune into Biden addressing what took place. And that man, we all know he's a puppet, but he is not going to ever apologize for making mistakes or admit wrongdoings or even go close to that. And so it's really shameful watching him. It's like he, in my opinion, a true leader can admit when they've made a mistake. And we all know he's not a true leader, but you just hope that at some point in time, he can do the right thing, but that's not the case. And it's time for him to be impeached and also resign already. But then that leaves us with a concerning future as well. So, and we have somebody here. So our guest for today does a great, I was just thinking of Harris, and she does a great impersonation. And when I told our producer Juan that she was the one coming on, he was fanboying for sure. He's like, what? We've got VP Harris coming on today. So that was really cute. So that's exciting. But let's go ahead and do this. Juan, can you play the video of Dahlia so we can show everyone who we're talking about?
So this just came out in the news this morning. Kamala Harris' flight from Singapore to Vietnam delayed until tonight over a report of a recent possible anomalous health incident. Okay, first of all, I don't think herpes is anomalous. I'm just gonna put that out there. And then it goes on to say, reportedly a case of Havana syndrome. Last time I checked, it's called hyena syndrome. Just wanted to clear that up for a friend, okay? You guys take care. Have a blessed day. Bye-bye.
Oh my gosh, that is hysterical. Ah, kills me. All right, let's go ahead. We're going to bring her in right now. Come on in and thank you so much for your patience and for joining us today. How are you?
Hey, I'm good. How are you?
Doing all right. Thank you so much. I have to know, well, one, you've gotten so far. I was looking at TikTok and I believe you have two TikTok accounts. Is that correct?
I do. One's political and then one is funny.
Okay. You've made it to a 500,000 on at least the Harris one. So that's really incredible. And that's with all the censorship out there. So nice work. And I think all of us creators want to know what the trick is to to staying afloat while they're trying to shut us down.
Learn how to write appeals because you're going to be doing it a lot. Make sure that you try to keep your content as PG as possible. Other than that, okay. I don't know. I mean, that's how I've done it. It's worked for me.
That's good to know. You know, I do drop quite a few F-bombs in some of mine. And so I could see, they like to say mine's hate speech. And so I'm like, okay, maybe the F-bomb is the hate speech. I don't know. I just had my very first successful appeal though with TikTok and they apologized and put my video back on there. That is the only one I have ever had that happen with. So that's good to know that the appeals sometimes do work. Oh man. Well, that's fantastic. I want to do something. I want to dive into, this is like what my audience is used to. I really want to understand what drives you to take the time to get the word out there, to get the truth out there. And you do it in a very digestible way, which is so refreshing. But what has made you this great patriot that you are today?
Oh, I think a number of things. My parents are both ordained ministers. I also have gone through a liberal stage myself. I have kids, which is always a good factor. I do go to church, but just had, I think that what's led me to where I'm at today is, as far as being patriotic, is just knowing who I am as a person. And I think if you don't, you'll lose your way. So,
Absolutely.
you have to be hardcore, in your beliefs and who you are.
I want to talk a little bit more about this liberal moment that you had. Can you tell us when that began? What drove you to go in that direction for a period of time? And then what got you back on track?
I think, well, being a pastor's kid, you learn a lot of things about yourself, and I think I always said that I was very sheltered, but I think a lot of it was I just went through a bad phase for 10, like it was nearly 10 years from like 19 until I was 26 years old. It was just a rocky road and a really lost time for me. So it was a lot of discovering who I am as a person and an individual outside of my parents, outside of my home. So, and I think that's what kind of pushed it. But there was also some incidences that I prefer not to talk about, but I mean, that's in a nutshell, that's what happened. So I think a
That's
lot of pastors'
interesting.
kids, if you're watching this, yeah, a lot of pastors' kids go through that.
I totally get it. What's interesting, the only thing I can really relate to since I'm not a pastor's kid is my parents were health nuts. And so when I lived under their roof, I didn't get to eat anything that's not good for you. And when I moved out on my own, I gained 20 pounds. And so I feel like I can plug that into that scenario because it's like you get a little taste of freedom and you're like, I want to do everything that I have not been forced to do for the past 18, 20 years. And then I found my way back and realized, oh, you're eating like crap. You know what I mean? But it's similar where you don't get that taste of freedom, or in that case, you don't get that taste of maybe the liberal lifestyle or just everything that that entails, and you go for it, and then figure out, maybe there's a reason that wasn't
Oh,
what I
yeah.
was doing. I
Most
totally get that.
definitely.
I have so much respect for those that have made a transition like red-pilled, because like I would say just for me, like just my upbringing's always been red, and then I just stayed that way. But for someone to actually be open-minded enough to, in a sense, be red-pilled and come back, I think that takes a lot of strength, and not everybody is open-minded enough to hearing the truth and pivoting back. So I think that's really admirable.
Thank you. Thank you. I think going to college also, I was going to tell you this, going to college, I had a Republican side. So I was rethink everything that I was going through at that time.
Oh,
So.
interesting. Yeah, that can do it. So you're in Oklahoma now, right?
Yes, I am.
And but you aren't originally from Oklahoma. Did you grow up in the red state that everyone wants to move to in Florida?
Yeah, I grew up in Key West, Florida.
Key West, nice. And so how has it been? Is it culture shock being in Oklahoma now, or what's the transition been like?
I've been here for almost 20 years and I'm so ready to go.
Okay.
There's nothing here.
Oh yeah.
It's not like Florida at all. And the schools are not as good as Florida.
Okay, that makes sense. I had a
But I
friend that did
mean,
a little
it's.
nursing stint there, and he said he didn't like Oklahoma at all. Oh, so it sounds
The people
like.
are nice. Don't get me wrong. The people are
Right.
great. It's just everything else, I think. For me, it is.
Yeah. Right. No, that makes sense. Hey, we've got Wade on here, Mayor Wade. I know he's your
Yes,
buddy.
hey.
He's actually the first one that told me about you. Oh gosh, it's been like, I feel like it's been almost a year. How long have you been doing the social media postings?
Since last April.
Okay. Yeah. No, that's great. That is, I feel like I started in June of 20, and I remember Wade recommending your accounts to me on TikTok. And so that's awesome. Yeah. He's kind of like family.
One of a kind.
yeah, absolutely, for sure. I know. All right, so I want to talk about, so you mentioned earlier, so being a parent has also helped you want to really have support more of a conservative lifestyle and the conservative, let's just say just patriotic and just loving our country. And so talk to me about, I'm just curious, what is it like having kids in school in a red state? I mean, it's tough because I know that there's pockets everywhere, but where you're going to have leftism. But has it been a relatively positive experience raising your kids in Oklahoma?
I'm probably not the best person to speak out about this because I've had some horrible experiences. At the time that I moved here, we were Oklahoma's 49th, and now we are 47. So that's the last I heard, but I haven't had, I mean, the elementary school, I can tell you, has been phenomenal. Everything else, I'm a little not happy. I mean, I'm not happy with. I've had my kids come home and say some things from school that are inappropriate. Just basically that they can do whatever they want to and that they're young adults now and they can make their own choices and stuff like that, that I just don't feel is acceptable. So, right. And I think it's playing a role in what's going on today.
Oh, absolutely. No, that's tough. I didn't realize that. Yeah. And that's the thing. It's like, I'm in Oregon and our education system is, I mean, there's pockets where there's a lot of funding and it's doing well, but overall Oregon is not in a good place either. And I had to make the decision to homeschool my kids this upcoming year. And it's a bunch of factors, the masks, the COVID testing in the classrooms and, all of that combined, but the same thing. I mean, we have the education system is one of the worst in the country, in many counties here. And it's just wild. And I don't know if you saw this, our governor signed something to where you can graduate high school without passing any of the state standardized testing. So you don't have to pass the basic reading, writing, or math to graduate high school in Oregon anymore. And and it blows my mind because I'm not a great student. I'll just say it. I don't really learn in a classroom setting, but I had to have I remember this, to graduate high school, I had to know, I had to fill out a blank map where the states and all of the capitals. And that's like something we know they're not doing that today. And that's so basic, right? But it's just sad that we're dumbing down America, really. And that's acceptable to so many.
That's what it feels like.
Right. Absolutely. So I want to know, I know we talked about what got you to where you are. I'm just so curious on, you have done so much with your social media, and I love how your, like I mentioned earlier, your content is so digestible because there's so much negativity happening right now, and it can be completely overwhelming to listen to repeatedly. And your approach is awesome because you're doing it. It's a lighthearted approach. But you're still getting that message across, which is so crucial. And I'm curious, did that just come natural for you, or was that a strategy that you chose in April when you got started?
Oh yeah, there was no strategy. This was just for fun. If you look back at some of my content, a lot of it started because of my divorce. And then it just ended up on the Heels Up Harris Foundation. So, no, just kidding. But yeah, that's how it kind of just ended up.
I love when it's organic like that, because then you're like, this is me and this is what's coming out. And that people really resonates with people and they gravitate towards it. It's so refreshing, and it's pretty unique with the conservative content to have the humorous delivery. And so for anyone watching right now that doesn't already follow, can you give your handles where we can find you?
It's It's at On the Daily with Dahlia, On the Daily with Dahlia, and that's on IG, Instagram, and a YouTube channel. I just actually started it and got my name, but
so awesome. But
across the board, it's the same handle.
That makes it easy. I like it. All right, let's see here. What do we have? Heels Up Harris Foundation in the house. I love it. Is this one of your friends?
It is. She actually did a really good podcast about schools the other day. So,
all right, to check Ashley out for sure. What else do we have? We have some folks that have been typing in, and I haven't integrated them into the conversation. I know I missed Wade earlier. Little known fact: Fern, Iowa has the best school in the nation. The school SKOOL of Hard Knocks. Yeah, baby. Mayor Wade in the house. I'm so bummed that I missed Fern Days. Oh, schools indoctrinate.
4th of July.
I know. Wouldn't that have been fun? Schools indoctrinate with activist teachers with union protection. Yeah, they do. They absolutely do. I know the Portland public school system, they just announced today that parents are no longer allowed physically in the schools any longer. And I'm like, that's frightening. And that's for elementary. And imagine sending your child to kindergarten, but you're not allowed to go in with them. And they didn't even say due to COVID precautions, they just straight up did it. And I'm like, oh, that's lovely. So indoctrination camp, that's for sure. Late again, hell's bells. Yeah, hey, you know what?
Go ahead.
Sorry about that.
It's okay. I'm so not used to this camera thing. But I feel as though I feel like it was almost in preparation, but they've been leading up to this point. I remember going up to my son's school and there was like I had an emergency and I needed to talk to him, and they were like, well, what's the emergency? And I'm like, unless you're going to feed him and clothe him and provide for him, I don't have to tell you anything. You need to produce my child.
Yeah.
Like, I am hands down that mom. And the fact that you can't just go into your child's school, that's a little disturbing in my personal opinion. I don't know.
Absolutely.
So
it's completely. And you're not allowed, you can't volunteer in the classrooms anymore. And they're using COVID as the reasoning, but we all know it's not COVID. It's because they're indoctrinating our kids. And
right.
And call me, you know, people can call me a conspiracy theorist, but that's what's happening. It's pretty wild. So yeah, I can't even, I mean, it's so sad that we can't even send our kids to school without fear of what they're doing behind closed doors and what they're telling them and teaching them. And they're so impressionable. Why can't you go in? I'm assuming they're saying it's COVID protocols. I'm sorry, I couldn't read the handle, but they didn't say specifically. So happy we were able to connect everyone here tonight. Yep, we got Drew on here. Yeah, no, I am too, Drew. And sometimes someone just said, why are we running late? So just so you guys know, our producer is a pilot. And so sometimes there are delays. and we are currently training a co-producer, which is Drew. So that way we have backup, because being a pilot can make your schedule unpredictable. That is for sure. Here I is. Love it. But yeah, I'm just, with everything going on today, and I don't want to be negative with Afghanistan, but it's just such the reality. It's just, I'm assuming you know people in that have fought in Afghanistan, Iraq, and it brings up so many emotions for so many. And I don't know if you've had any interactions with anybody recently that served. I haven't, and they seem like they need to talk. Like, I'm offering grown men that I don't really know that well. Like, you can just tell they seem like they need to talk. And so I've, you know, been able to be an ear as much as possible. Have you experienced that at all?
Yeah, it's really sad. I actually did a video about it, I'm so sorry. I did a video not too long ago, but it was just for 4th of July. And it just, the fact that we have to even, I don't even know. I feel like we're like the only ones pulling for our military, which is really, really sad. And
yes.
I mean, losing someone in Afghanistan, he was a friend. So it's not like it wasn't, I mean, he lost a child. The child grew up without her dad. So it's hard for a lot of people to talk about. It's one of the subjects I did not want to talk about. Just especially after today, it's just so rough. And I think a lot of people, I know as well as myself, I felt very low all day.
So hence the reason
I look like this, but.
No. Really, I mean, it's totally understandable. It is. We're human too. And it's like, I have a podcast. Yeah. You know, you're a social media personality and you put a lot of great stuff out there, but we keeping it real is so good for everyone to see. And that we all feel just absolutely disgusted and horrified by what is happening right now. And the lack of accountability and ownership coming from our leader. It just makes it that much worse. Wade just said, has she told you that her brother, I'm assuming, is in Israel? I don't know if that's something you want to talk about or not, which I understand, but.
No, I'll talk about it. He's not military, but he is in Israel and he said it was like 80-something% vaccinated. However, it is, according to the news, I've heard several reports. Of course, you can't trust hardly anything these days, but they're going into another pandemic and they're about to lock down. And I'm like, well,
wow.
And another thing is my brother's older. So he's like in his 50s, 60s. And they were down for a couple weeks, few weeks with getting it. And so now they're facing another pandemic. So I think that people need to open their eyes to the fact that, not saying that they should or shouldn't get the vaccine, because that's what I love about America is choice. But at the same time, I feel as though people need to be aware of all of the circumstances, like question to themselves, okay, wait, if they did that in Israel, why are they still going through what they're going through? It's a big sign that something's wrong.
Right. So. Exactly. Yes. Now I've been watching, it's a wild video and it was like 45 minutes long. I watched it, but, and it was the doctor that helped Trump and helped Giuliani when they had COVID, treated them, I should say. And he was speaking to Israeli leaders about that exact thing. Like, you guys are the highest vaccinated in the world, yet look what you're facing. You're facing, your numbers are skyrocketing. And so it's a huge waking up point. I won't go into what the video said, because it can be emotional for some to watch. I will put the link in the comments, but it was a real eye opener. And for those in Israel, especially these were Jewish people, it's almost like, it was almost like they were feeling like there's a genocide happening in a different form, almost in like a back door, the vaccine. It was really heavy to watch, because here they think they're doing the right thing for their people. And it's just a real eye opener on what's happening. Yes, actually that is, yes. Dr. Vladimir Zelenko, is it Zelenko? Yes, that was. So some of you have seen that video, it sounds like. Probably the most powerful video about COVID that I've seen, about the vaccine. So you guys can look at that. Have you seen that one?
I have seen it.
Yeah, that's heavy. And especially when at the end, I think that rabbi was crying. And because he just realized everything that's happening and what the future potentially holds for them. And so anyways, and if anyone hasn't seen that, it's worth the watch. It's about half hour, 45 minutes, but it's absolutely worth it. And I agree with you. It's all about choice. We should have the choice to get the vaccine or not. And it's just scary what's happening here. Sure, you can trust the government. Just ask an Indian. Oh, yeah, that's a good point, Steve. Oh my gosh. Impeachment for Biden. Yeah, a lot of people calling for impeachment. I would like to see him resign. And but that's not going to happen. If he couldn't even admit wrongdoing today, he's not going to resign. Too much pride there. His puppet masters won't let him. But what are your thoughts on that? Exactly. Do you think he's You think he's ever going to resign, or do you think they're going to impeach him? Any of the above?
Well, I've actually been working on something, but I'm pretty sure the 25th is coming, the 25th Amendment. So I
Okay.
honestly, I wouldn't, I think this is probably the calling for it, if it for it to take
Yeah.
place.
Right.
So it's, and somebody had just commented about, patriots standing up. It's time to stop talking about it and, do some action. So
Right.
it's
I
a call to
appreciate that
action.
very much. Okay, if you could have, let's close this up with what's a call to action for patriots out there? Like, I've talked about this last week. We can no longer have a silent majority. That's done. What is your call to action for those that are so disgusted by what's happening? What can they do?
There's a lot of freedom rallies going on. You just need to look around. I know that in Oklahoma, for instance, we had something down at the Capitol recently. There is, I mean, set up your own rallies. I mean, my thing is,
Yeah.
this is where I feel that it's really necessary. I was talking to a friend about this. It's like I want to, work on something about everybody being at the Capitol at the same time in all 50 states. Like, let's go.
That would be
But
rad.
right now it's so difficult. Yeah, we're working on it. We're trying to do what we can. So hopefully we can come up with something that's really, really positive and that will have an impact. But as of right now, I think that everybody's kind of living day to day on what is going on in the world. Like, it's just nuts. It's
Right.
crazy.
It
So I mean, it's like there's no perfect time, but now it's like we only have now. Like, it's down to the wire.
Yeah, it
Yeah,
really
something was
is.
supposed to shut down on the 31st. So, I mean,
Yeah.
honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if Patriots don't take to the streets by the 1st.
Right. No, that's absolutely freedom rallies in every state. Yeah, that is a great idea. I love that. That is super powerful. I mean, that happened when all the women, when Trump was inaugurated, wasn't it the same day that all these women with their vagina hats went and they marched through the streets? I mean, it's like crazy. It's crazy. Where are they today? But anyways, so that made national news. And I think if you could, and let me know how I can help with that. Pull that off. That would be so rad because they can't not cover that if it's happening in all 50. That would be really powerful. So I love that idea for sure. Yeah. All right, Oklahoma is
Yeah.
based. All right. Well, what do we have here? All right. Someone said just kidding, so I have to read it. We all know this mess is because of climate change. Yeah. Oh my gosh, climate change. Crazy. Well, yeah, that's why they're trying to get rid of
Yeah.
cows. In the state of Oregon, can't have cows. So you have to eat your dead pets. That's legal, but eating a cow would be considered illegal. Just so, I'll throw that in there. That's a bill they're trying to pass here in Oregon. But it's just
Yeah.
bananas. All right. Well, thank you so much for
It's
coming on, and just keep doing what you're doing. You're awesome, and I really like your material. It's very digestible. And when
you.
I just recently started watching your stuff again. I took a TikTok break because I was pissed off at TikTok, but I just recently started watching your stuff again, and it's nice after a day of heaviness to be able to laugh at just how asinine VP Harris especially is. So thank you for that.
Yeah. Yes, thank
All
you. Well,
right.
thank you so much.
Thank you for coming on. We'll talk to you soon.
All right. You have a good one.
All right. You too. Bye-bye. All right, you guys, thank you so much. That was so great. Like I said, thank you for hanging on. I know we've had a few schedule blips, but we're working on getting a little more consistency. So I appreciate you guys tuning in. It means the world to me. It truly does. I actually delayed my camping trip 1 week so that I could come in, or excuse me, 1 day so I could come and hang out with you guys because it means a lot to me that you invest your time in watching and I want to do the same consistently. So thank you. And please don't forget that we are partnered with MyPillow, Mike Lindell, and our code is RAM, RAM. You get a hefty discount code. I've gone in and actually done it because I wanted to see how hefty it is. It's good. So try that out. And that way you can support us and that all tracks back to us. And for legitimacy, and it helps us get our name out there as Right America Media's Ram TV. So, So appreciate that. And then hang on after me. I like I told you guys last week, I've been really enjoying the loaded mic. I really like the banter. And then after the loaded mic, we have Counterculture Mom, which is another great spin on really just what's happening out there from a mother's perspective, but fathers as well. So please hang on for those two great shows after me. And then I will see you next week live on time. Thank you guys. Have a great night. Good.